Hey, what's up? Husband here. I hope you're all having a great day. I sure am. In the last few weeks and days, I've been working more and more on new productions and more specifically trying out new stuff. And I stumble across something that I stumble across every other month or so, that I want to create some new ideas for lead sounds and don't keep repeating myself with the lead sounds and really trying to find cool ways to introduce new kind of layers and how to find new ways to combine them. And for this, like the last few weeks, I've been looking to more towards hardstyle and how they do it. Thought I needed to go a little bit deeper into that to really understand how they get everything so well put together. So I bought the Audiotrix tutorial pack, which is like a long video about how they do their stuff. So I thought let's share it with you guys so perhaps you can learn something as well. So I thought let's share with you guys what I've learned so that you can learn something yourself. Open the project here, which is a project that I've made specifically only for the making of this lead sound. And normally I do the lead sounds inside the project itself, but for this one I really want to dive a little bit deeper into the creation of these hardstyle leads. So as you can see, there are a lot of layers. I have chord 1, chord 2, lead dirty, bass, bass 2, main synth, add synth, synth effect, vox, noise and impact. All. Lots of different stuff. So I thought it would be best to just start with letting you hear how it sounds, which is the whole combination will sound like this. So that's basically the whole combination with all the sounds together, and I think the most important thing to start with is the lead sound itself. There was one new lead that I've made, which is like a square kind of lead, which sounds like this. I made it in silent. As you can hear, lots of movement, lots of delay, lots of distortion. I'll share the preset for you so you can have it in the next Patreon pack. So not to worry, you don't have to go through the hustle to walk throughout all the steps that I've made to creation of this lead. Now, the first thing you notice is that something I don't do a lot with these kind of leads is that I actually did a lot of delay on it. So, and that's all just for the reason because I want to have everything snappy, but if you have everything really controlled, there's not a lot of movement going on. So that's the first synth that I came up with. Now, with the synth, I needed some chords. So I made one chord layer, which I basically took the same preset that I saw Audiotrix use in their tutorial. Shameless, but I know. It's just a serum preset which is called Hypersaw. It's made by Jordi Das. Like on its own, it will sound like this. Now, the first thing that you notice, it doesn't have a lot of harshness to it. And that's something that I've learned from the Audiotrix tutorial, is that they told me that it's really important that in hardstyle that those Supersaw, or those Hypersaws in this case, really have a lot of, they add a lot of the width and the harmonies. They don't interrupt all the other leads happening around it. So it's really important that these ones are really clean and clear. And so the next thing that I did with this one is to just add some EQ, take away the highs and the lower frequencies and just boost a little bit around the 1K. And then add a glue compressor, which I started using a lot as well because I saw that I thought hardstyle didn't compress a lot, but I was wrong. So they actually compress a lot. So I put a glue compressor on this one specifically to really make it pump. And normally I would also use the OTT, but the OTT in this case would add some additional sounds and additional frequencies and some clipping frequency, which I didn't want. I just want to have it clean and really wanted to really stick out of the mix. So without it, with it, just real smooth. Now add some reverb on the sound itself. Taking in mind this reverb cut here, I just use the main mid frequencies and then I also send it towards this reverb return to just give it that extra bit of width, and which is of course being side changed by the chord itself. Now the next one that I added then, I felt like it was perhaps good to first listen to it how it sounds with the other one. So we have the main synth and the chord. And as you can hear, really snappy. I really carefully made the notes of the, specifically the chords and the main lead really snappy, that they don't go from one into another but have some space in between. And now with this one, I also use a lot of pitch bending, so you really get that cool vibe with the glide function. Now, the next one is again a chord. Actually, it's a plucked chord, which I thought was really cool to add a little of an attack to it. Again, compressed it with the glue compressor, really mildly, just 7.3 dBs in the threshold. Again, to create a little bit more movement than if I would do it without it, which would be really static. Now, what I've noticed is that I've tried a lot of leads. I tried the heroic lead, I tried a lot of leads to accompany this main synth because I felt it was a little bit too thin. But then I thought, like, perhaps I just need to use that main one as just a middle lead and then have a really dirty one on the side which doesn't influence the other one that much. So I came up with this lead, which I tweaked a little bit to give it that cool width. So I took a lot of the low frequencies, added some little reverb, and then add some great compressor from Waves. I normally use this one a lot of on vocals, but it's also really good to add a little of a attack to the sound it's being put on. So without it, and this one I did really heavily, like to really give it that feeling that it's all fitting together. So when we combine the things that we have now, we have the main synth, we have the lead dirty, so creating the width. Then we have one chord, giving the harmony, bringing everything more together. And then the additional pluck to give it that punchiness, that attackness. Now this would be, before adding bassline, this would be my main lead layer. So then I added some bass to just accentuate those lower notes. Really simple init patch that I made. Don't know if you can hear it yet, it's really, really simple. But just to announce the individual notes a little bit better. And then I added another bass line, which is like being sidechained by the first bass lines. It's just a really muted bass line, but I felt without that bass line underneath it, it would become really static. There's not a lot of things happening in the melody. There's like a few notes, but there's a lot of spaces in between. And I thought this bass line would fill up that really open space a little bit. And it's really subtle. Mute these ones so you can hear how this will sound. So already pretty cool going, but then I felt like I wanted to have that little weird sound on top of it. And I saw Auditrix use a lot of plucks and stuff on top of it to really give it that width and to really give it that atmosphere, so it's not all really straight to the point. So I found this really cool. I actually made this. Yes. It's actually a pad from one of the Patreon packs, which sound like. But I noticed when playing some short notes, you can make it into a plug as well. So really wide. So again, accentuating those mid frequencies, just removing the low and the mid frequencies. Adding some delay, OTT, and reverb. And you'll notice when I bypass it and then add it later on, it will become much more open, the whole lead layer. So without it, and with it. So I think a really substantial change, which really makes it a bit more unique as a layer. Yeah, the last one is basically just an announcement, the thing that Maurice West does a lot and has been done a lot of hardstyle, just basically a pitch bend which goes towards the first note. So we get pretty straightforward. And then before I go into what's on the group, I'm going to show you a few things, which is like the vocal, which playing like it's a background vocal to really give it a little bit more atmosphere. So it's this one. Add that on top. Body. And then the boring stuff, the impact and the FX, which is basically just a noise and an impact. And then you have. All right. And then the last thing that I want to mention is that I've compressed the hell out of this group. When I remove the glue compressor here, It's like in your face all the time, which I don't like. So I thought let's just compress it all the way. So here, this is really snappy and this is all over the place. And that's basically how I did this. And it might sound like I'm telling you this right now in like, what are we at? 5 minutes or something, 10 minutes. It might sound really easy, but it took me like a week for it to get really the way it sounds now. And I probably will come back to it later and think it's still missing some stuff and But quite happy for the moment. So yeah, that's how I did this. Well, I really hope you enjoyed this video and I really hope this helped you creating better lead sounds, and I hope that this gave you a better understanding about how to get your lead sounding well in the mix and what kind of techniques you can use so that you don't need to have the super saw that much in your face if you have other sounds that can fill in that place. In my personal opinion, I really like this technique because then I have a more cleaner and more professional sounding mix in the lead sounds. Now, it will have a pretty distinctive sound, so it will sound more hardstyle ish, big room ish. So if you're, for instance, going for trance sound, this probably is not for you. But for creating these kind of unique layers, I think is a really cool technique. So that's for me this week. Now, before I go, I just want to mention my new track Warriors is coming out this Friday on In Harmony Recordings by Andrew Royale. I'm really looking forward to what you guys hear of it, and here's a real teensy little preview. Take care, bye bye. So I thought, clear. So, now.